ultimately, that's the goal of our industry, the telecom industry, is to work with our customers, whether those are individuals like you and me, or businesses and corporations, or public sector, the government, to come up with ways and use cases for 5G to actually get to work.
This is Horizons, stories about what's next in the world, powered by Compass Data Centers.
So the G in 5G stands for generation. That's it. It's nothing too complicated or too technical. If 1G through 4G, if you think about it like a house, 1G was the single-story house. 2G was adding a second story. 3G was putting in a garage. 4G was the gazebo in the back. 5G bulldozed the entire house and rebuilt a new one. It is a complete reimagining of a network. It is completely new from the ground up, from below the ground all the way up. So a question I get asked a lot is, what can I do with 5G that I can't do on 4G? And there's a couple of different answers. On the business side, on the enterprise side, the answer is a ton. When thinking about emerging technologies and how those technologies get used, it's helpful to think about it in layers. At the very base layer is connectivity. And without connectivity, nothing really exists. Nothing really happens. And so something like 5G, with its ultra reliability and its low latency and its high bandwidth, allows businesses and organizations to really begin exploring how to maximize efficiencies, how to reduce costs, how to not necessarily replace workers, but allow them to do different things. 5G brings with it capabilities, massive amounts of speed and bandwidth, microscopic amounts of latency. One of the fears about new technologies, especially things like automation, the fourth industrial revolution, artificial intelligence, 5G, is that it's going to eliminate jobs. Maybe. With every industrial revolution, from the steam engine to the printing press to the first computer, there's been this concept of creative destruction, where as new capabilities become realized, others are made redundant. Cloud computing brought with it the lack of a need for robust internal IT departments to manage on-prem server instances. That doesn't necessarily mean that the whole IT function went away. There's still millions of people employed as IT specialists. The nature of the job changed. And we see the same thing in manufacturing. As automation increases there, there's a question about jobs. And I think what we're seeing is that some jobs are changing. Some functions are being made obsolete, while others are growing and others are being invented. And so as 5G brings new capabilities in areas of compute, as it changes the way that we think about hardware, as it changes the way that we interact with hardware, some functions, yeah, they become obsolete, but others grow to take their place. And so, in one sense, advanced connectivity's role in changing how we work is a tale as old as time. Some jobs go away, other jobs are created. Innovations aren't created in a vacuum. And so what I tell these people is to be careful. As they're thinking about their own innovations, as they're thinking about what can 5G do for me, they need to understand that their suppliers are asking the same questions and they're making the same innovations. Their partners are asking the same question. Their competitors are asking the same question. Most importantly, their customers are asking the same question. What is all of this doing for me? And how is it going to impact everything from my supply chain to my methods of production, distribution, how I engage with my customers or the things around me? This is all changing in real time. And it's happening a lot faster than it ever did before. So the challenge for innovators and creators is to be aware of this rapidly evolving ecosystem that's all around them. The analogy of skating to where the puck is going to be has never been harder, and it's never been more important.